CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... E.G. Marshall. I'm sitting over here in this shaft of moonlight. A curious thing, the moon. The songwriters have hailed its praises for centuries. By the light of the silvery moon, shine on, harvest moon, moonlight and roses. All love songs. And Claude Debussy's most popular piano piece is Clair de Lune, or Moonlight. Yes, the moon has held a fascination for lovers, poets, and musicians. And in our story about to unfold, moonlight plays a rather important part. But it has nothing to do with love. Quite the opposite, I believe.
Yolanda, what in the name of heaven are you doing?
I'm going out on the balcony.
In your bathing suit? At night? In mid-October?
I must. I have this urge to bathe myself in the moonlight. The harvest moon, see? How bright and big it is.
Yolanda, come back in and get dressed. You just cannot...
But I must. I must take a moon bath.
Our mystery drama, Garden of the Moon, was written especially for Mystery Theater by Bob Juren and stars Kim Hunter. I shall return shortly with Act One. More and more women today are finding self-expression in business. Not just jobs, but careers. Yolanda Westerville began her career with Roberta Dean Cosmetics as a typist. But her natural flair for the cosmetic industry soon propelled her to the executive suite as vice president in charge of merchandising. The competition is fierce, and up to now, Yolanda was a front runner. But lately, it seems that tension is catching up with her.
I don't care if you have to charter a plane. That display has to be in St. Louis Monday. We went over this four times, Charlie, and now you're telling me... I will not listen. You're all against me. That's what it is. Well, let me tell you, Charlie, you're not getting this office. Oh, no. I know all about you and your filthy little schemes. Roxy! Roxy, get in here with your pad.
Mrs. Westerville, you've got to calm down.
Don't tell me what to do.
Here, take this.
What is it?
Take it.
Oh, all right.
It's only a simple sedative.
God, what's the matter with me, Roxy? Just made a fool of myself on the phone with Charlie Benson.
I heard. It's been happening more frequently lately. Oh, why don't you take a few weeks off, huh?
No, not with the campaign on Sunset Reverie ready to break.
Well, then take vitamins.
Roxy, sometimes
Mrs. Westerville, you know you're under a lot of stress. Diet, exercise, vitamins build you up. You know, you cope better.
Is that how you put up with me?
I enjoy working for you, Mrs. Westerville. But I'll be honest, lately you've become a bit of a shrew.
Oh, I know. I've been spouting off at home, too. Bill's unhappy.
Oh, I think you're just run down. That's why I'm serious about the diet and the exercise.
Roxy, you're a friend. But I don't think wheat germ and yogurt are going to make much difference.
Look, a new health food store opened on Lexington Avenue at 45th Street last week. It's called the Garden of the Moon. I haven't been there yet, but why don't you try it? It's a restaurant as well as a store. So why not go there for lunch or at least look around?
Well, why not? I'm sick of those martini and steak lunches. Garden of the Moon.
Good morning, madame. May I help you?
I'll just look around, thanks.
If I may, Dr. Lunestra at your service. Our merchandise is not the usual type of food you find in most stores, such as this.
Oh? Well, I'm a novice, really. I'm not into the health food thing, so everything's new to me.
Ah, then you must let me guide you. We're quite new, you know, and we haven't caught on yet. I have no other customers, so let me explain.
All right, go ahead.
The name of my shop, I did not choose from mere whim. It is basic to my merchandise, such as this jar of body lotion.
Essence of lunar light.
Precisely. And this display of produce, carrots, beets, cabbage, potatoes, they are not ordinary vegetables, although they appear no different than any other.
Oh, I've read of organic gardening.
Madam, these are not organically grown foods. They are superior to those.
Oh?
These are grown in moonlight, and only moonlight.
Moonlight? You're serious?
Oh, yes, of course. You see, it is a theory of mine that moonlight has enormous benefits.
It usually gives me the creeps. It's so cold and icy.
Ah, no, madame. It is magnificent. What we call moonlight is, of course, the reflected light of the sun. And when the sun strikes the surface of the moon, it picks up powerful forces, magnetic and atomic. Moonlight is imbued with incredible properties.
Well, I hadn't thought of it that way.
So, all of this produce is exposed only to moonlight. Therefore, it has nutritional benefits beyond imagining.
Really? I'm not sure I...
I see. Madame doubts. I know. Others will doubt, too, but when they see the results of eating moon-grown food, they will eat nothing else.
Where is the moon food grown?
On a farm in New Hampshire.
New Hampshire?
High on a mountaintop to get the best exposure to the moon.
Well, thank you. Look, I really must go.
Please, take this free sample of lotion, and you will be back, madame. You will see.
He's crazy. Growing food in moonlight on top of a mountain in New Hampshire?
That's a new one, all right.
Who's going to fall for that? It's just a bunch of vegetables from some Jersey farm. I got out of there as fast as I could.
I'll get it. Mrs. Westerville's office?
Hi, Roxy. Is she there?
Yes, sir. It's Mr. Westerville.
Hello, Bill.
Hi, darling. How goes the day?
Don't ask.
Look, can we get out of Bridge tonight? I've got a crash brief to get ready for court tomorrow.
I'll call the Maxwells now. I couldn't face it tonight myself.
Oh, great. Meet me at Alfredo's for dinner, and then we'll go straight home, huh?
Okay, I'll see you there.
I think I'll take a look at this Garden of the Moon. It sounds so weird.
Don't waste your time. Whoever it is that runs the place is a charlatan. But I think I'll take your advice about diet, Roxy. I'm meeting Bill for dinner tonight, and I think I'll stick to cottage cheese and tomatoes.
What's with the cottage cheese and tomatoes?
Roxy thinks I need a diet. She says it'll help my nerves.
Yeah, well, they could stand some help.
I know, Bill. I've been a bear lately. It's been the strain of the Sunset Reverie introduction.
Yeah. Still, a diet wouldn't do you any harm.
I'll get Roxy to work out a schedule for me. She's a health nut, you know. Oh, and speaking of that, I went into the strangest shop today.
Oh, yeah?
A new health food store called Garden of the Moon.
You in a health food store?
Yeah, Roxy suggested it. Bill, I think there are grounds for prosecution or something there.
Oh, why?
Well, the man who runs it, a Dr. Lunestra, claims all his produce is grown in moonlight. It's supposed to have magical powers.
Well, that's a new angle. Dr. Lunestra, he's appropriately named.
Aren't there grounds for some legal action? I mean, it's misrepresentation or something.
No, not unless someone files a complaint. Well, who knows? Maybe he does grow it in moonlight, and there are plenty of suckers who'll believe it.
No, it doesn't seem right, no.
Well, he's probably not hurting anyone. If someone does react badly from the stuff and lodges a complaint, well, then that's a different story.
I guess you're right.
Good morning, Roxy. Good morning, Mrs. Westerville.
Any calls?
Mrs. Dean called twice. She wants to see you as soon as you come in.
Oh, Lord.
Carpenter and Rose called from St. Louis. The display still haven't arrived?
Oh, this sure is going to be my day. Tell Mrs. Dean I'm on my way. And pour me a coffee while I put on my face.
Right away.
Oh, well, I'd forgotten this.
What?
The sample of lotion that character gave me yesterday.
Essence of Luna Light. Why don't you try it? It can't hurt.
It has an unusual fragrance.
Yeah, it seems to glow.
Well, a little under the eyes and some on the neck. Snap it up with that coffee, Roxy. Roberta Dean awaits.
Back already?
She's fuming about the St. Louis opening. I'm going to have to fly out there. Look, get me an early afternoon flight and call my husband and tell him to meet me for lunch at Alfredo's. Hold all calls except for Her Highness. I'll be back Thursday if I'm lucky.
Westerville here.
Hello, Bill. It's me.
Hi, darling. How's it going out there?
Smashing. I finally traced the displays to St. Joseph, but we got them here in time. The opening was a huge success.
Great. When are you coming home?
I'll be in Sunday night.
Good. I'll meet you.
No, don't. Roberta and I are going to the office first. I'll see you at home.
Okay, I'll be there. Hey, you sound as though things are great.
They are. Wait till you hear the compliments I got. See you Sunday.
Must have gone well. I haven't seen you this radiant in years.
One of the best line introductions we've had.
Well, maybe it's the firelighter. Not having seen you for 5 days, but you do look different, Yolanda.
Yeah, I've noticed it, too.
Hey, your skin seems so much smoother. I mean, particularly under your eyes. It's like a younger woman's. What is it, a new Roberta Dean transformation?
No, in fact, I'm not wearing any makeup.
Oh.
I've been using a bottle of lotion I got in that strange little store I told you about. It has a marvelous tightening agent. I'm going to try to make an exclusive deal with him for Roberta Dean.
You're going to market this stuff? I mean, a week ago, you were practically calling him a charlatan.
Well, I still don't believe the moon nonsense. But chemically and cosmetically, his lotion works. I'm going to have our labs run an analysis on it. If we can't duplicate it, we'll talk business with him.
What does the great Roberta think about it?
I haven't told her yet. There's a new moon tonight. It looks so picturesque over the Empire State Building.
Where are you going?
Just out in the balcony. It is beautiful up there.
What is it, darling? Something the matter?
Just a tingling in my face. Like little nerves jumping.
Yeah, no wonder after a week in St. Louis. You better take a hot bath and go to bed.
Good idea. Tomorrow I'm going to pay another visit to this Garden of the Moon.
Ah, good morning, madame. I thought you'd be back.
Well, business certainly has picked up.
Oh, yes. In only one short week, I am becoming known. I can hardly provide enough produce to meet the demand.
Well, I think I'll try some of your vegetables.
Certainly. Did Madame use the lotion I gave her?
No, not yet. But I've been thinking about your moon-grown food, and, well, all these other people seem to enjoy them.
Here, let me give you a small assortment to try, and be sure to steam them. Don't boil. Takes away all the flavor.
Yes, of course.
2 carrots, 1 parsnip, a potato, and 4 onions. I think you'll find them quite different from the vegetables you've been accustomed to. And remember, we serve lunch and dinner, too. Perhaps you'd like to have luncheon with us sometime?
Perhaps. Speaking of the lotion, what's in it?
Moonlight, madame?
I mean the ingredients.
Oh, nothing but a little oil of roses, water, and gelatin. And moonlight.
But water and gelatin can't... Well, that's very interesting. I'll really have to try it.
Here are the vegetables, madame. I guarantee you'll notice a decided difference in how you feel after eating the produce from the Garden of the Moon.
How much do I owe you?
$2.
That's fair enough, I guess.
And be sure to steam them.
Here you are.
Thank you, madame. Enjoy them in good health. Just browse around, everybody. I'll be back in a moment. If you want help in selecting, I'll be happy to oblige. Back in a moment.
Lunestra here.
How are things going? We haven't heard from you for more than a week.
Splendidly. The merchandise is moving beautifully. People are coming back for more. In fact, I'm running low on supplies.
We can take care of that.
When will the next harvest take place?
On October 30th.
Good. Word is spreading. I'm getting new customers every day.
Excellent. We'll keep in touch and see that you get more supplies.
By all means. I don't want to have to turn anyone away just when we're beginning to get a name.
Someone once wrote a song about moonlight in Vermont. Perhaps that's where the farm should be located instead of New Hampshire. Even so, it seems a long way to ship produce for a New York store. I wonder, though, do you really believe carrots and potatoes will grow in the moonlight? Or that moonlight has special powers? We'll see what happens after Yolanda eats the moon-grown vegetables when I return shortly with Act Two. Moonlight can be different things to different people. Some find it soft and romantic. Others think it cold and eerie, like Yolanda Westerville. But I doubt that moonlight can add nutrition to vegetables. They need sun to flourish. It is curious, though, that the lotion Yolanda used did seem to make a difference in her appearance. Both she and her husband noticed it. And what did Mr. Lunesta say was in it? Oil of roses, water gelatin, and moonlight?
You're actually going to eat those carrots?
Well, look at them. They're absolutely no different than any other carrots I've seen. And they taste superb.
And they were grown in moonlight.
Well, I still don't believe that nonsense. They're probably organically grown and cost twice as much as the supermarket variety. It's the lotion I'm interested in.
Yeah, well, you do look different, I'll admit that. Softer.
I sent the rest of the bottle to the labs today. Positive we can duplicate the formula.
You feel like a movie tonight? For once, I don't have homework to do.
Let's. I haven't been to a good...
What's the matter?
Just... I don't know. A sudden kind of warm rush through my whole body.
Sounds like the start of a cold. Maybe we'd better just stay home.
I guess so. Better just get to bed early.
Yeah, your resistance ran down during that St. Louis campaign. Why don't you get into bed? I'll fix us both a hot lemonade with a spike in it, huh?
There it is again. Oh, dear, I'd better start nursing myself. I can't afford a bout with the flu this week.
What? Yolanda, what are you doing over there?
Just standing here in the moonlight. See how it comes through the window, so soft and clear. Makes a white patch on the carpet. I'm just standing here in the moonlight.
Yolanda, come back to bed. You've probably got a fever. It's making you...
No, I don't think so. My skin is cool. Cool in the cool moonlight. So cool.
Yolanda, stop it, please. Look, come on. I'll help you back to bed.
Oh, all right. I'll say goodnight to the moonlight. Goodnight, moonlight. Morning, darling. Oh, thanks for making the coffee.
Well, I didn't expect to see you up so early this morning.
I feel marvelous. Good night's rest made the difference.
I chased that flu bug right away. Huh,
good night's rest indeed. You were out of bed standing in the moonlight. You were talking to it.
I was what?
You were standing by the window talking in your sleep.
But that's... I don't remember it at all. Oh, I'm sorry I disturbed your rest.
No, there's nothing to apologize for. I'm just glad you're feeling okay. Got a busy day ahead?
Not really, but an interesting one, perhaps. I should get the lab analysis back on that lotion. Good morning, Roxy.
Morning.
Any calls?
Not one, believe it or not. Say, you're looking good this morning. Better than I've seen you in ages.
Had a good night's sleep.
No, it's more than that. Oh, there's something different about you. Oh, this arrived by messenger this morning. Confidential from the lab.
Oh, great. I was hoping that would come in today.
Mm.
I had the lab run an analysis on that lotion I got at the Garden of the Moon. I hope we can duplicate it.
Oh, you think it's good?
Oh, look what it's done for me.
Ah, that is why you look different. Younger.
I used half the bottle. It definitely works. Well, I'll be.
What's the matter?
The analysis of the lotion. Oil of roses, water, and gelatin, just as he said.
That's easy to duplicate.
But those ingredients haven't any cosmetic value. There must be something the lab missed.
No,
they're pretty thorough. I'm going to call them. I can't believe that combination of elements could be so effective. I'll see if they can duplicate.
Laboratory, Harrison.
Eric, it's Yolanda Westerville.
Hey, good morning, Yolanda. Did you get the analysis?
Yes. I'm wondering if you missed something.
Missed something? What do you mean?
Rose oil, water, and gelatin. Are you sure that's all?
Yeah. Where did you get this fluid anyway?
Oh, I'll tell you that later. Look, I'd appreciate another test. If it turns up the same, we'll forget it.
Sure. You'll be hearing from us.
Thanks. Bye, Eric.
Well?
They're rechecking.
I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to that place on my lunch hour and get myself a bottle.
Look, I'll come along. I'll treat you to lunch at the Garden of the Moon.
This is jammed. It's certainly catching on.
We'll have to wait for a table. That's the proprietor over there.
Oh, odd-looking guy, isn't he?
Oh, he's coming over.
Welcome, ladies. You're here for lunch.
Yes.
I have two in the back. Follow me.
Oh.
Look at those fresh strawberries on that woman's plate. There's his golf ball.
Incredible. Thank you.
And how did Madame enjoy the vegetables?
Excellent, really. I only tried the carrots.
Oh, then you ladies are in for another treat. The lunch menu.
Oh, let's see.
I think I'll have the tomato surprise.
An excellent choice, Madame.
So will I.
Two tomato surprises. My assistants will take your beverage order.
This place is really packed. You know, I've been thinking... You admit the lotion did wonders for you. Maybe the food does have some kind of special something.
It's possible. I still think the moonlight thing is just a promotion gimmick.
Two tomato surprises for the ladies.
Oh, will you look at that? What are they stuffed with?
The chef's secret, madame. But you might happen to find a rose petal or two.
Exotic.
Bon appetit, ladies.
Simply marvelous.
Oh, I agree 100%.
Oh, it was so light and tasty, yet so satisfying.
Yeah, I'm going to take some more vegetables home. Bill won't touch them, but... Roxy, what's the matter?
Nothing, really. Just a sudden warm feeling.
Not you, too. Oh, God, it's the flu bug going around. I had the same thing last night.
No, I'm okay, really.
Look, you take the rest of the day off. Go home and get into bed.
Oh, now that I won't turn down. I do feel a little dizzy.
Let's pay the check and go.
I want to get a bottle of that lotion.
Oh, do that. And give me a few drops for the lab. I'd like another test from a different bottle.
Did you enjoy the luncheon?
Excellent, yes.
I'd like a bottle of essence of lunar light.
Yes, of course. Shall I add it to the check?
No, I'll just...
Oh, yes, put it on the check. It all goes on the expense account, Roxy.
Thanks. I guess I better get on home, Mrs. Westerville. I feel kind of funny.
I'm afraid Roxy's going to be out for a couple of days.
Oh?
We were having lunch at the Garden of the Moon. She came down with the same thing I had last night.
You had lunch at that place?
Yes, it's a small restaurant, as well as a store.
Yolanda, is something the matter?
I've got to do something.
Well, what, for heaven's sake? Yolanda, well, are you all right?
Yes.
Well, what's so important that you jump up from dinner like this? Yolanda, are you feeling sick again? Yolanda, what the dickens are you doing?
I'm going out on the balcony.
In your bathing suit? At night? In the middle of October?
I must. I have this need to bathe myself in the moonlight. The harvest moon. Oh, see how big and bright it is.
Yolanda... Would you come back inside and get dressed? I mean, you just can't...
I must take a moon bath.
A moon bath?
Bathe in the light of the moon.
Yolanda, you're not being rational.
Is it so wrong to enjoy the moon?
Something's happening to you. I mean, last night, now this...
I'm beginning to appreciate the moon.
I insist that...
No! Don't touch me. I feel wonderful. So cool. Ooh, so cool. I can feel the moonlight seeping into my skin. Through my body. It's incredible. Dr. Lunestra is right. Moonlight is magical. The force is flowing through my veins. Vitalizing. Purifying. Cleansing me. Every cell, every atom of me.
Yolanda, come inside.
Yes, it's too chilly out there. But the moonlight felt so good.
Do you know what you just did?
I took a moon bath. I didn't expect to see you in today, Roxy.
Oh, I feel great. Whatever it was didn't take hold. But I don't know if I should mention it. It's just too silly.
What?
Well, during the night, I woke up and I just had to get up and stand in the moonlight.
You too? I went on the balcony for a moon bath.
Oh.
Bill thought I was crazy, but I had the most fantastic sensations.
Like a force through your body.
Exactly.
Well, I went back to bed. And this morning, I felt better than I have in years. And me a health food nut to begin with. Let's have lunch there again.
There's something about that food and moonlight that's out of this world.
Welcome, ladies. Apparently, the Garden of the Moon agrees with you.
I have to admit that it does.
Then you and your friend will be interested in this invitation. I'm passing them out to my regular customers.
Garden of the Moon weekend retreat.
Yes. To the farm and resort in New Hampshire, where all our produce is grown. We've scheduled it for the October 30th weekend. There'll be a seminar on the power of the moon, and we'll have lots of time for meditation and study.
What does it cost?
Oh, no cost at all. We'll go by chartered bus, and naturally, everything on the farm is already provided for.
Oh, that sounds fascinating. We'll have to think about it.
Do not hesitate too long, madame. I've had many reservations already this morning. And I promise you, it's a weekend you will not want to miss.
It sounds inviting, doesn't it? A weekend in New Hampshire would be a welcome relief from the New York City pace, no matter what the circumstances. But this trip sounds especially exciting, since Yolanda will visit the source of this unusual food. I hope she and Roxy decide to go, don't you? I'd hate to miss out on a trip like that. If they can get away, we'll go with them when I return shortly with Act 3. Weekend in New England sounds like a great idea, and it seems that Yolanda Westerville has her heart set on it. Of course, it's a perfect opportunity for us all to learn more about how this food is grown, to visit the farm and see firsthand where these unusual vegetables come from. But Yolanda's husband, Bill, has some very understandable misgivings.
Are you out of your mind, Yolanda? Go off to a mountaintop in New Hampshire with a bunch of moon nuts?
It's only a weekend, and it sounds intriguing.
And frankly, your hang-up with moonlight all of a sudden has me worried.
I don't see anything to worry about. I'm enjoying it.
I forbid you to go to this witch's Sabbath or whatever it is in New Hampshire or any place else where I wouldn't know exactly where you were.
Oh, Bill, there'll be 50 or 60 of us.
Don't be naive. Eve, Yolanda, you have no idea what or who is on that mountaintop.
It'll be fun finding out.
I want more details on exactly what and where this place is.
Well, I suppose I could find that out.
Yeah, I should think you'd want to. I certainly do.
All right, I'll get all the details I can. And if we don't come back, you can come looking for us.
It's not a joking matter to me.
A simple weekend in New England in the fall. There's nothing sinister in that.
Ah, yes, madame, I can appreciate your husband's concern. Others have asked for the location, but we really prefer not to divulge it. You see, we would be overrun with curiosity seekers.
Yes, I guess you would.
The trip is open only to Garden of Moon customers, people who believe, as I do, in moonlight. If, however, madame thinks she cannot make the trip...
Oh, no, I really want to go.
We will leave from here on Friday, October 30th, at 6 p.m. sharp.
Phil, just have to go along with it.
Then I can put you down for a definite reservation.
Yes, and for my secretary, too.
Splendid.
Well, we'll be there. Now, I've got to get back to the office.
Good day, madame. Lunestra here.
We're ready for October 30th. Are you?
Almost, yes. I have 4 more open reservations, but I know I'll have them filled.
Good. The harvest is splendid this month. We're looking forward to your arrival.
We're all set, Roxy. I made a reservations with Dr. Lunestra.
Is Mr. Westerville still so set against you?
Yes, but I'm going anyway.
Mrs. Westerville's office?
Yeah, is she there, Roxy? It's Eric Harrison.
Oh, she's here. The lab.
Hi, Eric. What's the story?
Yeah, that second sample tests out just like the first. There's no difference.
I see. Well, I thought I was on to something.
I'm so sorry. We couldn't come up with what you were expecting, but that's the way it goes.
It's okay. Thanks, Eric.
Bye.
Well, I'm going to have to make a business deal with Dr. Lunestra. His secret ingredient defies analysis.
You can talk with him on the weekend retreat.
Exactly what I intend to do.
Still set on going to New Hampshire, eh?
We leave day after tomorrow.
Great. I'll come down and see you off.
Well, you've had a change of heart.
I don't think there's anything to worry about. I was concerned about that stuff you were eating. I thought that that's what was giving you hallucinations.
Hallucinations?
Yeah, but the carrots from the Garden of the Moon are just plain old garden variety carrots.
How do you know?
Well, I had one analyzed.
You what?
Yeah, I took one of those carrots to an old college chum. He's with the Department of Agriculture.
And what did he tell you?
Well, no higher nutrients. Nothing special about it, except one thing. He said it had been grown in very poor soil. So I asked him if it could possibly have been grown on a mountaintop in New Hampshire.
And?
Well, he gave me a strange look and said, yes, it could have. I told him the story and he just laughed. I don't think you're in any danger. Just surprised that you would fall for this guy's line. But if you enjoy it, go ahead.
But, Bill, you've seen the change in me. And I've felt it.
Okay. I just wanted to let you know I won't stand in your way. Have a good time. Go off to New Hampshire and enjoy your Garden of the Moon.
This is the first time I've been out of town for a weekend in years.
It's too bad it wasn't earlier in the month. The foliage up here would have been glorious.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention? We are turning into the driveway now. We have arrived at our humble resort. Fortunately, we have a bright moon tonight. Your first glimpse of our Garden of the Moon will be just as it should be, in full moonlight. All your luggage will be taken care of, and after you've settled, we'll gather for an evening snack. Off the bus, everybody, please.
It's freezing. But where are the buildings? All I see is a mountain.
Entirely underground. My assistants will soon be opening the gardens to the moonlight. They are up on the summit. We'll visit them later.
This is fascinating.
Ladies and gentlemen, you'll kindly follow me. Don't be alarmed. Once inside the mountain, you'll find our accommodations quite comfortable.
Everything underground. How unusual.
Yes, it is necessary for privacy and convenience. During our retreats, we will never see the light of day, you might say. Welcome, everyone, to the Garden of the Moon.
How beautiful. It's so modern.
This is the lobby, of course. Sleeping quarters are on two upper floors. Dining and recreation are below. We will visit them all.
Well, everything's so gleaming.
Cleanliness is another secret of our success. Ladies and gentlemen, my assistants will show you to your individual quarters. After you've refreshed, we will assemble here.
Well, you said the place was modest. I'd call it elegant. Small, but elegant.
We think of it as compact. Come, let me show you to your quarters. If you'll just step inside the elevator.
A moving broom closet, I'd call it.
But compact, eh? You see, our layout here is all up and down. In fact, from top to bottom, our establishment is 700 feet.
Really?
But for practical purposes, somewhat narrow. The hallway is circular, you see, with the rooms surrounding it. Here we are. These are your quarters. Again, compact. Make yourself comfortable and join us in the lobby in 1 hour. Just take the elevator.
Okay. See you later. Look, our suitcases are here already.
What's the matter, Roxy?
I'm nervous.
Why?
This place is so closed in.
You're not claustrophobic, are you?
No, not that. But it's so strange. I feel like I'm in a submarine.
Well, that's part of the novelty, I suppose.
Why don't you take a hot shower?
There doesn't seem to be a tub, but the shower will relax you. Then we'll join the others.
Yeah, maybe I will.
And cheer up. We're here to enjoy ourselves.
Well, I do feel better. Just the excitement of the trip, I guess.
Just in time, ladies. We're just about to start the evening.
You mentioned a snack. We're famished.
Yes, of course, in a little while. Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. As you can see, the wall panels are sliding up to reveal a circle of seats. Would you all kindly be seated? We are going to start our weekend with a short explanation of why we are here and what to expect. Now, you may think it strange that each of the seats has a belt. Kindly fasten yours across your lap. It's just part of the experience. We are now lowering a screen on which we will vividly demonstrate tonight's experience. Let me know when all belts are in place.
This is weird.
I don't get the belt bit.
For some weeks now, you have all enjoyed the produce from our humble lunar garden. And this weekend, we'll top off that experience. All belts in place?
Yes.
Good.
What's happening? Oh. The whole place is shaking.
Is it an earthquake?
And now for the explanation you all so well deserve. If you look at the screen, you will see the planet Earth from half a mile up.
Oh, my God.
You see, my friends, we are in a spacecraft on our way to the planet Lunaris. I am a Lunarian. The planet Lunaris lies undiscovered on the far side of the moon. Oh, I can readily understand the disbelief on your faces. Is this some kind of joke? Some theatrical trick? I'm afraid not, my friends. You are all destined for the planet Lunaris with me. You see, in dining on our moon-grown foods, you have been purifying yourselves. Tenderizing might be a better word. For this is harvest time in the garden of the moon. Lunestra here calling Lunaris.
Come in, Lunestra.
We are on our way. A fine harvest aboard. I suppose I'll be going out again shortly.
I am afraid so. The director wants to lay in something oriental. You'll bury the ship in Mount Fuji and open the shop in downtown Tokyo.
All I can say is that the Lunarians seem to have the gourmet flair. I wonder where their appetites will lead them after that. A bit of French fare, perhaps, or Polynesian. At any rate, Yolanda and Roxy are certainly going to be late for work come Monday. It's all very well to follow a new fad, but it's mighty dangerous to follow people you don't know to moonlight retreats in New England. I'll have some more thoughts on the moon when I return shortly. Sitting in this shaft of moonlight. If you don't mind, I think I'll move over next to you. I felt a sudden chill. The next time I look at the moon, I'm going to wonder about that undiscovered planet that lies behind it and whose people cultivate gardens here on Earth. I wonder if the Lunarians could have something to do with all those unexplained disappearances we hear about every year. Our cast included Kim Hunter, Paul Hecht, E.V. Juster, and Ralph Bell. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown.
This is E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.